Barotruchat è un vitigno che si conosce da oltre due secoli. The Barotruchat vine has been around for over two centuries.
It is mentioned in ampelographic bulletins published by the House of Savoy in 1877, when it carried out a census of all its vineyards. Barotruchat was already known as a white grape variety, with origins in Almese, close to the mouth of the Susa Valley, and in Villabasse, Avigliana, and Buttigliera.
E poi se l'erano perse le tracce perché
then we lost track of it. I think this was due to the fact that people generally left the countryside and simply abandoned the vineyards. At that time, a small industrial revolution was taking place, and peasants and farmers found working in the factories easier than working the land.
Susseguirsi dei cambiamenti economici, per cui c'è stato l'abbandono delle campagne.
The Barotruchat was gone. There was no more. But we all remembered it. My grandfather and my father talked to me about it, but the Barotruchat we uprooted from the vineyards in the 60s was gone. The rediscovery took place thanks to Giorgio Falca, a friend and fellow countryman who unfortunately passed away a few years ago. He had a traditional Piedmontese toppia, pergola, with a huge shady Barotruchat vine with a 20 cm a thick trunk climbing over it. It was a historic pre-phylloxera vine, which his grandfather had planted in the early 1900s.
Giorgio
Falca took a bunch of grapes and a branch from the vine to the Faculty of Agriculture in Grugliasco, which fortunately is not far away. They took it and compared it with the Barotruchat they already had. The CNR and the Faculty of Agriculture became genuinely interested, and after 3 years of ampelographic research, discovered that this vine is unique. It has no affinities with other existing vines, which increases its value. At the same time, the first vinification experiments were being carried out on this vine at the Bonafous Experimental Winery in Chieri. After 3 years of hard work, this was the final product, pure, vinified Barotruchat. This is when Barotruchat began its comeback. I fell in love with it because I had the chance to taste the first bottle during the official presentation of this new discovery. Just like St. Paul on the road to Damascus, I was thunderstruck, and I planted the first vineyard in 2007, which is the one we are in now. Anyone lucky enough to get a chance to taste it will discover its characteristics, freshness, aromas and flavor. It immediately makes you think of a white wine from the Aosta Valley or one from South Tyrol. But no, this is a Piedmontese vine called Barotruchat.